Good morning and happy Wednesday to you. I am excited to get this day started and I am getting a really, really exciting package today. But I gotta do some work before that comes regardless, because as soon as it comes, I highly doubt that I'm gonna be able to stay focused on anything else except for that. Hope you're doing well. Thanks for being here. Let's get this day started. Multicam. Well, I finished editing the ceremony, I'm now exporting it, and while I wait for it to export, I wanted to start a new segment in every single vlog, basically called the question of the day, and I want to try to answer every question within 60 seconds and make it really valuable to you. There are so many questions that you guys ask all the time that I think are super valuable, and instead of just commenting on them, I'd rather answer them so that you can hopefully see them in the vlog, and then there'd always be a question of the day. And if you're interested in whatever the question of the day is, I will always have the description below with the question and the timestamp specific. Specifically where it is in the vlog if you want to just jump to that. But I hope you're not a person who just wants to jump along. I hope you watch it all. So since I am working from home and that's what I do all the time, the very first question I want to answer is, what do I miss most about working for a large organization and business? And really the answer to me is really, really simple. The only thing I really miss is people. I love obviously talking to people and meeting people and just constantly building relationships with people. And without question, the hardest thing about working from home is the fact that most of the time it's just me in my office. Obviously my wife and family are upstairs, but I don't just talk to them on a regular basis. And while it can kill productivity when I was working for a larger organization because I can have conversations that kind of take me out of my creative mindset, I really do miss the conversation and just the constant hallway talk and just taking a quick walk in the building. And just I love people, so it's really hard for me to just be trapped sometimes in my house all the time. I wouldn't trade it for anything in the world, because obviously I love what I'm doing right now and I love the fact that I have total flexibility to do kind of what I want on a per day basis. But if you want to ask what I really miss about working with people, it's people, because I love people. So I mentioned that I obviously love to do all the ceremony edits and all the speeches and everything right away and then export them and bring them back into Final Cut. And in case you're trying to figure out why I would do that, what it allows me to do is bring back the clips, bring them back in edited into Final Cut. And the reason that I like that is because when I go through the clips and I do my favoriting like I always do, and I can choose the best parts of the clips, well, when I do it this way, I can actually favorite them the same way that I favorite other clips. So I can go through the ceremony, go through the speeches all the way that I prefer, choose all the sections that I really, really like, and then if at any time I just want to bring those specific parts into a film, I'm not having to worry about choosing the right camera angle and choosing the right audio source and doing everything. I basically have the right camera already chosen, the audio already synced, the audio already sounding great, and then I can just use it in a film. Hopefully that makes sense. Also, I think I've said this before, but anytime I'm doing a doc film, if like a doc film was part of what the couple got in their package, I will always do the doc film and all the doc edits before I do the main film, because I have to do them anyway, and when I'm able to look through all the footage and get everything done first, I have a better understanding as far as what stuff I want to use when I actually get to the editing of the actual film, so I just find it more beneficial to do all the doc stuff first. If they're getting just a trailer or just some sort of short feature film and nothing else, then I will just dive right into the actual feature film. All right, I need a little change of scenery. Let's go. Man, it's a nice day out. I wish someone would have informed me. I would have left earlier. Oh, and on a side note, someone had mentioned in the comments that they wish I would just be honest about my Starbucks sponsorship. If I had a Starbucks sponsorship, I would have a whole lot more money. I'm telling you that much. Oh, whoa.
Dude, that Starbucks sponsor is coming along late, isn't it?
Yeah. Obviously, I know that not everybody knows me well enough to know that I'm a pretty honest person. I really say what's on my mind and I'm honest about it. So, if I had a Starbucks sponsorship, I can promise you that I would be telling you about it like crazy, and I would be constantly telling you why you should use Starbucks all the time. I just love Starbucks as it's a great atmosphere. But if you work at Starbucks and know somebody that does and they want to offer a sponsorship, we would gladly, gladly take it.
All right, gotta get my last refill.
All right.
You work hard.
So productive short trip to Starbucks. It was more just actually to meet with Pablo for a little bit. He is basically just making lots of phone calls right now for different opportunities that are coming about. One thing that I've learned in leadership, and I've learned about specifically as I've been growing my business, is that I'm a firm believer in the fact that people should be put in a position to succeed, and they should be doing what they do well, or else you're not really utilizing them enough. And when I brought Pablo on, obviously one of the biggest reasons that he came on board was to get more work, and specifically to build relationships with clients that we already had, and he's fantastic at that. So while he helps me with editing and helps me with different things here and there, he's really, really good at the relationship side of things, and that's more important to me than just having him do things that aren't really his specialty per se. And it really isn't about whether or not he's good at the editing, because he's done a great job anytime that I've asked him to edit anything. It really comes down to the fact that if he's really, really good at something else, I'd rather utilize him in that form before I utilize him in something that I can obviously do, or I can hire even a different person to do that actually really, really loves editing. And I've always just felt that it's kind of silly to try so hard to train somebody to do something that isn't necessarily what they're best at or that they enjoy the most, because people are always going to do their best work without question on the things that they really enjoy doing. And so it would make no sense for me to hire somebody like Pablo, who is outstanding with people, who's outstanding with relationships and conversations, and have him sit all day behind a desk and edit. That would just be silly. It wouldn't really make much sense. I just think way too many people try so hard to be good at so many things that they end up not really doing better at just what they were already really good at. And if you're really, really good at something, you should really try harder to do that and make that your focus. Don't try to be someone that you're not. Don't try to hire somebody that's not what you want them to be. I'm all for getting the right people for the right job, not just getting somebody and training them to hopefully do what you think that they should do or that you need help in.
Oh, I'm excited.
All right. So this won't really make the reason I say this won't make a ton of sense right now is simply the fact that I can't really give you all the information of what we're working on. All I can say is that we're working on stuff, ideas, some different projects. So I can't specifically say exactly what yet, but very soon I will. Then it will make a little bit more sense to you, and you'll wonder, why in the world did an A9 just show up at my house? And look at this lens, the G Master 85 1.4. Oh my, wow, that thing is huge. And also the 70-200 2.8 G Master. It's a pretty sweet lens too.
Look at that lens. This lens. Oh my gosh. First of all, it's the biggest lens I've ever seen in my life.
Okay, just... so we just switched to Sony. just kidding.
All right. Well, enough playing for now. Initial impressions of the A9 are wow. So this is completely non-scientific, but this is the A9 with the 85 1.4. This lens is insane. Really good. And I gotta say one thing, that full frame sensor, man, I kind of miss that full frame sensor. But the night is still young, there's still lots of work to get done. I'm gonna edit for the next hour and a half or so. It's just before 6 o'clock, but Kelsey's at a small group tonight for the church. I still have a meeting tonight with a bride. Lots of meetings happening recently. This is the big season from September to December-ish that we get a lot of inquiries for weddings. So
super useful audio recorder tip, listen.
This is ceremony officiant lav, September 16th, 17th. Very simply, anytime I start a recording with my audio recorders of any sort, the very first thing I say the minute it starts recording is what it is and the date. Sometimes I forget the date, but I always say what it is right away. Then that way, as soon as I get into the audio edit here, I hit play and I hear that right away. I don't want to have to skip forward and wonder if it was the groom or the officiant or the bride, or I don't want to know any about that. I just want to know exactly what it is immediately. So I always right away hit record and I say it. Ceremony, groom, lav, September 16th, or officiant, lav, or DJ tap if I have a microphone that I can say that in. You get the picture. It's convenient. You should do it.
Okay, the day is going. The day is cruising by. Is it sad that I still have this much Starbucks left and I'm headed to a meeting at Starbucks?
Well, I had a great meeting. Everything went really, really well. It seems pretty certain that they're gonna book us. Really excited to possibly add them to our 2018 lineup, which is filling up quick. I don't meet with every single couple. Sometimes I just have email conversations, sometimes phone calls, but if they're local, I'm all for meeting with them if that's something that they prefer. And I always go into every conversation without expectations, and I also don't go in a sales pitchy way. And all I really do is try to build a relationship immediately to get them to see how important the relationship is to me, more than just simply the transaction of them booking us. That's super important to us, and they really like that, but it's also the truth. I don't go in there trying to sales pitch my way into a sealed deal, if it's called that. I just go in trying to be kind, be courteous, help them understand that we actually care about them as people more than just the actual job, and it works out pretty well. But that wraps up a great overall day. I'm really excited to just continue to share some exciting things that are happening at 4LC Studios, and I'm excited that you're along for this ride. I feel like I know some of you personally from just so many comments and just being a part of this community. I'm just super thankful for this. It's actually fun for me to pick up the camera to tell you about new ideas or to tell you about things I'm learning, because it's just this community that I really, really appreciate. And when I started this vlog, the idea was to provide value, but when I first started talking to the camera, I didn't really feel like I was talking to anyone specific because there weren't tons of people watching. And now a lot of you watch all the time and comment all the time, and it's just awesome knowing that I know what some of you are going through, dealing with, some of the questions you have. It's just really, really been exciting for me to continue to just have this conversation. But that's gonna wrap up today. Fantastic overall day. Really looking forward to tomorrow. Still waiting to hear back in confirmation on one possible job that could be really exciting. If I get that confirmation, you will know about it in the next vlog because it will happen tomorrow. If you don't see anything exciting in the next vlog, it's because it didn't happen. But you'll just have to wait on pins and needles.